You're watching Tag TV.
From Kashmir to Kanyakumari, India is a spellbinding mosaic of culture, tradition, languages, and an extraordinary mingling civilization. Keeping its age-old culture maintained, today the country is taking huge strides in the path of development. Hello, I'm your host Yeshi, and today in our episode of My India, we bring you some of the stories that will give a glimpse of our country's diversity. Amid COVID-19, many city dwellers realizing that they may be restricted to one place for a relatively prolonged period of time are flocking to offbeat destinations to self-isolate around nature. So today, we take you to the beautiful Loktak Lake in Manipur, which is being thronged by a number of tourists who want to spend their time in the serenity of nature and not in confined spaces during this pandemic.
Leaving behind the noise of the city and fear of the pandemic, tourists are flocking the Manipur's Loktak Lake to surround themselves with the serenity of nature. Located near Moirang in Bishnupur district of Manipur, Loktak is regarded as the largest freshwater lake in the northeastern region of India. Spread over an area of 286 square kilometer, the lake has earned the laurel of being the wetland of international importance under the Ramsar Convention. The iconic lake is famous for its circular floating swamps, also called fundus in local language. Resembling like miniature islands, they are found in various forms floating in the lake, covering a substantial part of its area. One among these fundus is a small unexplored island named Mandha, which is becoming famous among the tourists for offering a resort facility.
I heard this place long back time, but this is the first time I'm visiting here. So yesterday we have visited here and we stay here one night, and it's a very pleasant here, and everything is very fine here. We are here 24 members here in this one, all our families, my sisters, my brother-in-laws and my sister-in-laws, we all together 24 members here, including my this one daughters, childs and this thing, sons.
Small structures like huts have been built up on the Mandha Island for the staying purpose. Tourists can stay as long as they want, ranging from days to months. Here, they get to enjoy a complete rural lifestyle. They cook themselves, spend their time playing karaoke, or do swimming in the crystal clear waters of the lake. A boating facility has also been introduced by the Loktak Lake Tourism Development Society for tourists, enabling them to enjoy the nature by close.
This place is amazing and we have a lot of fun at here. We dance, we sing, and still we have the catwalk at here also.
Famously known as the Alexandria of Manipur, Loktak is considered as lifeline of the state due to its importance in socio-economic and cultural life. Besides providing drinking water to the entire region, it also serves as the source of income for many fishermen who largely depend on it. And now, by developing island resort at Mandha, more opportunities are being generated for the local youth of Thanga, a tiny village located around the buffer areas of the famous Loktak Lake.
Ngasi mag Mandha Island Resort ay na ay nasiyangot sa bagi asadi. Thang dala iba lagli suheraga thawak pangdaba naharol jingda thawak kara pizza ba ngamzena bagi asada amadi lam koiba lakpa kangu singna loktak yengninge herga loktak sida loktak mayai de leiba ithat sida kana su udana leramba du petribi gi mayam adegi lam koiba mayam singda hena uhanjaningba amasung akhoi gi loktak te leiriba asengba loktak ki nga sing petribi gi mayam da mahok tanganingba adegi lam koiba mayam singda pijaningba adumbagi asada maru oiba md thawak phangriba yut singda hena thawak piba ngamgi ngamnabgi asada asigumba resort asi aina tawjegi bune aina thamjegi.
Loktak is like an entire ecosystem in itself with a rich varied collection of flora and fauna. It is home to 233 species of aquatic plants, more than 100 species of birds and 425 species of animals, including the Indian python and sambar. Presently, the lake is under the supervision of Loktak Development Authority, which is trying its best to develop and preserve the lake.
Feeding the hungry amid the COVID-19 lockdown remains a tough challenge. A number of individuals and organizations have gone an extra mile to provide free meals to the destitute during this time. Today, we will see how the kitchens of religious organizations are contributing their bit to serve the cause.
In desperate times like these of the pandemic, it becomes very important for all citizens to join hands and feed the hungry and destitute. Due to the lockdown imposed on a number of places and entire families being quarantined, individuals and organizations all over the country are offering their services to provide free meals to those in need. Among the major help givers and supporters, the name of India's mega kitchens, which are usually run at religious sites, cannot go unmentioned for providing 2 square meals to thousands of individuals on a daily basis.
इस धरती पर जन्म लेने वाला सब अपना बंधु है, भाई है, परिवार है। इस परिवार के लोगों के लिए हम सबका कर्तव्य बनता है, जितना कुछ कर सकते हो करना चाहिए। भगवान ने हमको सामर्थ्य दिया है, हम उनको सेवा का अवसर दिया है, हम स्वयं और साथ ही साथ ऐसे सभी श्रद्धालुओं से निवेदन करेंगे इस आपदा की घड़ी में मानवता की सेवा के लिए अपने कदम आगे बढ़ाएं। जन जन की सेवा ही भगवान की सेवा है, ये मान करके सबको आगे आना चाहिए।
In many cities of India, members of ISKCON or International Society for Krishna Consciousness are distributing free food to the needy amid the pandemic. ISKCON is an organization that has been doing social work in different countries. They have also worked on the ground level to provide their services during the pandemic to the poor.
हम लोग ISKCON की तरफ से ये सेवा कर रहे हैं। 50 फैमिली को हम लोग खाना घर में जाके दे के आ रहे हैं, क्योंकि जिसका घर में खाना बनाने का वाला आदमी है नहीं, दोनों आदमी अफेक्टेड हुआ है और बहुत सारा जरूरतमंद के आदमी लोगों का पहुंचने का प्रयास कर रहे हैं हम लोग।
इन द कैपिटल न्यू दिल्ली, मेंबर्स ऑफ दिल्ली सिख गुरुद्वारा मैनेजमेंट कमेटी हैव स्टेप्ड अप to deliver food to COVID-19 patients who are quarantined at their homes. Men and women of the committee are preparing meals with adherence to all social distancing norms and are delivering meals to families in all 4 corners of Delhi. Apart from that, members of Sikh community are also delivering oxygen cylinders to help the patients and taking out sanitization drives to offer their bit to help the society amid the pandemic.
जो पॉजिटिव लोग हैं, जिनको घरों में रोटी नहीं बना सकते, जो बाहर निकल के अपनी सामग्री नहीं खरीद सकते, वो लोगों के लिए हमने यह सुविधा शुरू की है कि पैक फूड यहाँ से जाएंगे और ये कोविड पॉजिटिव के लिए है। जो लंगर की प्रथा हमारी चल रही है वो अलग चल रही है, मगर ये कोविड पॉजिटिव के लिए जो पेशेंट्स होंगे, जो परिवार होंगे, उनको ये लंगर पहुँचाने का काम हमने ये शुरू किया।
Apart from that, religious kitchens of temples and a number of trusts are also working day and night to provide 2 square meals to the needy and help the authorities in the fight against the deadly virus.
Now, a roundup of some of the major stories that made news recently.
Authorities and non-profit organizations in Bhubaneswar city of Odisha are comforting hungry stray animals as they are feeding them during the ongoing 14-day lockdown. With roads and public places lying deserted, animals in many parts of the city were seen wandering in the streets in search for food.
होटल और सब बंद हुआ है तो लगभग 60,000 कुछ डॉग है तो उन लोग को खाने के लिए प्रॉब्लम और तो उन लोग रास्ते में लोगों को परेशान करते हैं डांट काटते हैं तो हम ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा कोशिश करते हैं कि जैसे ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा एनिमल को फीडिंग करेंगे और अच्छे से अच्छे स्ट्रेबल्स को खाने के इस कोरोना पेंडेमिक उसको जिंदा रखेंगे.
The state chief Naveen Patnaik has allocated $81,752 to feed the stray animals during the lockdown. A traders association in Chennai city of Tamil Nadu has converted school buses into oxygen on wheels in order to supply the life-saving gas to COVID-19 patients before they get admitted to the hospital. The buses are equipped with oxygen cylinders and concentrator machines. Medical oxygen has become a major concern with hospitals across the country issuing SOS calls that they were running out of supplies of the life-saving gas because of the crush of patients.
Being home to 1.3 billion denizens who belong to different castes and communities, India displays an amazing characteristics of mutual tolerance and peaceful coexistence. Examples defining this unique identity of the country are to be found at its every nook and corner. One among them is a small village in Jammu and Kashmir's Anantnag district, where people of various faiths live together in complete harmony. Have a look.
मजहब नहीं सिखाता आपस में बैर रखना, हिंदी है हम, वतन है हिंदुस्तान हमारा. इफ वन नीड्स टू नो द एक्चुअल मीनिंग ऑफ दीज लिरिक्स देन दिस विलेज इन अनंतनाग डिस्ट्रिक्ट ऑफ जम्मू एंड कश्मीर वुड बी परफेक्ट प्लेस फॉर हिम. Known as Mutton, people of different sects reside here with peace and brotherhood. Be it a temple, mosque or gurudwara, the village has it all, making it a beautiful example of religious diversity. The local says that people of various faiths have been living here together for ages and have never let their religion create a rift among them.
मैं हम सब जगह घूमते हैं, हम हर जगह निकलते हैं. मेरे यार बरादरी इतनी है बचपन से, या मुस्लिम बरादरी इतनी मेरे यार दोस्त हैं, सब मेरा स्वागत करते हैं और हम भी उनके साथ रल मिलकर बैठते हैं. बहुत आनंद आता है, हमें कोई यहाँ महसूस नहीं होता है, हमें कोई यहाँ कोई कुछ नहीं महसूस होता कि क्योंकि यहाँ बरादरी है. हम बैठते हैं आपस में मिलते, वो आज भी आते हैं हमारे पास मिलते हैं, मिलजुल कर हम काम करते हैं, हर फंक्शन हम आते. मैं भगवान का परमात्मा का शुक्रगुजार हूँ, सबका परमात्मा का शुक्रगुजार हूँ कि यहाँ ऐसा माहौल है. ये माहौल मुझे नहीं लगता है कश्मीर में कहीं भी.
As per the evidences, before 1990s, the village had a greater population of Hindus and Sikhs residing together along with Muslims. However, in 1990s, due to insurgency, a number of Pandit families left the valley and migrated to Jammu and other places of the country. But after 1996, many families returned back, and today they are again living peacefully with their Muslim neighbors. today, be it happy occasion like marriage or sorrowful event like last rites, they freely visit each other's household and even help each other whenever required.
यहाँ का जो माहौल है हमारा एकदम बढ़िया है, सबसे अच्छा है, यानी कि पूरा वर्ल्ड में सबसे बेहतरीन हमारी ये मटन की एक जगह है, ख़ास इसकी अहमियत है। यहाँ पर मंदिर है, गुरुद्वारा है और बाकी जगह हमारी, यहाँ पर आगे हमारा मस्जिद भी है और आस्थान भी है हमारा। और सबसे अच्छी बात है यहाँ का कल्चर हमारा, हिंदू मुसलमानों, हिंदू का और मुसलमानों का और सिखों का एक भाईचारा है यहाँ पर जो कायम है अभी तक और आगे भी रहेगा, जो भी नई जनरेशन है उससे भी आगे आएगी।
The way in which Mutton Village has kept its tradition of oneness alive even during tough times clearly shows that no religion is greater than the religion of humanity.
Difficult times like that of the pandemic call for collective measures to be taken by the authorities as well as the citizens so as to collectively work for eradicating the virus from the country. Among a number of citizens that have stepped up lies the name of Tariq Ahmed, a houseboat owner in Srinagar who has turned his boat into a mobile ambulance for offering help to people amid the pandemic.
The COVID-19 pandemic has brought forth many acts of kindness where people have been going an extra mile in order to help others. A similar act of kindness has been witnessed in Srinagar city of Jammu and Kashmir, where a houseboat owner has started his own mobile ambulance in order to help the people amid the pandemic. Floating on the waters of Srinagar's Dal Lake, Tariq Ahmed's boat ambulance is expected to benefit thousands of people in the landlocked region. Equipped with all healthcare facilities, the ambulance also consists of a siren and a speaker that are used to make announcements in order to make people aware regarding wearing masks and other important things.
अभी जो हालात मैंने देखी है हॉस्पिटल में क्या है और लोगों के घरों के अंदर कितने पेशेंट्स हैं, तो उसकी वजह से मैंने भी इसमें थोड़ा और इम्प्रूवमेंट करने की सोचा है कि मैं इसको और भी डेवलप करूं। इसके अंदर मैंने स्ट्रेचर, व्हीलचेयर, फर्स्ट एड, ऑक्सीजन, ये मैं सब इसमें रखा हूं। इंशाल्लाह जैसे ही मुझे कॉल आती है, मुझे कॉल्स आते हैं रोज़, जैसे ही मुझे कॉल आती है मैं जाता हूँ, मैं उनको हेल्प कर दूँ।
Tariq Ahmed Patlu himself suffered from COVID last year in August. And it's due to the apathy and stigma which he had to endure during his recovery that he decided to start this service so that no one else had to go through the same. Patlu's initiative is receiving praises from all the locals who believe that it will help in saving dozens of lives.
एक्चुअली अगर अभी किसी का कोविड होगा तो यही एक सहारा है इंसान के लिए, क्योंकि हमें झील के अक्रॉस कर ले जाए और वहाँ से बाद में तो एम्बुलेंस वगैरह मिल जाएगी, तो यही एक सहारा है। तो ये बहुत ही अच्छी बात है क्योंकि अभी कभी किसी कुछ भी हो सकता है, अभी कहाँ से भी आवाज़ आएगी कि आ जाइए, तो बिल्कुल ये एम्बुलेंस रेडी है। तो तारिक साहब को इसके लिए बहुत ही अच्छा अप्रिशिएट कर रहे हैं हम।
एट प्रेजेंट व्हेन द होल कंट्री इज इन द ग्रिप ऑफ द पैंडेमिक, इन सच अ सिचुएशन a number of people like Patlu are coming forward and extending their helping hand to those in need.
Next, we bring you a few short stories about recent developments and happenings from around the world in our section called World in Focus.
This is a delicious Vietnamese coffee made by mixing condensed milk with tasteful coffee. Coffee along with a sandwich is a famous local breakfast in Vietnam. UCC is a coffee making company that contributes to coffee production around the world. It is known for high quality and sustainable production of coffee and is garnering attention as a coffee production area in Vietnam. Recently, the announcement of UCC Quality Contest 2021 Vietnam was held online, having participants from Japan and Vietnam. held since 2001 with the goal of developing coffee industry. This year, it was held for coffee farmers in Dalat City of Vietnam. UCC staff visited local farmers to access the taste of coffee and management of farm and to check with UCC original sustainable list. In UCC contest, 7 farmers won the prize. The winner was Li Thi Chung, who participated in this contest for the first time.
Mình là nấu của Việt Nam, là sản phẩm cơm thế giới, mà các bạn cũng đã mừng chủ.
This year, UCC Quality Contest is celebrating its 20th anniversary and the commemorations have been held in 6 countries including Africa and China. For the first time, UCC has set SDGs perspective on a checklist and it is contributing to the development of a new coffee culture around the world. Next, we take you to the capital city of Japan, Tokyo, where the preparation of Tokyo Olympic and Paralympics is in full swing. Symbolizing Olympic, the torch relay started on 25th March and is continuing around Japan. The preparations of Olympic are being assessed as the symbol of overcoming corona crisis. The torch relay started from National Training Center in J Village in Fukushima Prefecture, which suffered with Great East Japan Earthquake in 2011, and therefore it is a symbol of getting light over a big disaster. Last year, Olympic torch arrived in Fukushima from Athens in March, but the torch relay was suspended after the decision of postponing it due to pandemic. At present, a torch relay is going in Japan. No audience event is being held to prevent corona infection. People are watching it on television or using internet connection to enjoy and support the Olympic event. Japan's efforts to hold safe Olympic and Paralympic even in the time of coronavirus pandemic is wonderful showcase of Japanese dignity. David Hockney's sunrise, a message of hope amid pandemic, recently lit up Seoul's night at K-pop Square on Gangnam Street. Dozens of Seoul residents were seen gathering in front of large screen and watching the British artist's latest artwork entitled Remember You Cannot Look at the Sun or Death for Very Long, showing an animated sunrise in Hockney's iconic bright colors. The digital artwork, which was created with iPad, is a symbol of hope and collaborations as the world awakens from its lockdown to protect populations from COVID-19.
코로나 이전에 그런 삶에 대해서는 되게 많이 잊어버리고 살았던 것 같아요. 근데 오늘 작품을 보니까 여전히 일상은 아름답고 여전히 아름다운 해는 이제 뜨고 있다라는 걸 다시 한번 좀 기억하게 됐고 그래서 살만한 가치는 여전히 있다. 네, 이런 메시지를 저는 받은 것 같아요.
The screening of 2.5-minute video will be continued to be shown once a day for the month of May online and in the 5 cities including London, Seoul, New York, Los Angeles and Tokyo. For years, the journalists in Pakistan-occupied Kashmir have been demanding their rights, the right to access and report all that is wrong with the system. However, to their dismay, they have not been accorded any freedom. In fact, the government has ensured the information is denied and their voices are muzzled. Even the fundamental right of freedom of speech has been suppressed through intimidation or force. The local newspapers are forced to carry news praising the works of federal or local government, else they face censorship. A number of them recently gathered to deliberate and discuss the deteriorating standards of press due to such government measures.
Your right to information, access to information ka jo kanun hai, usko yahan pe ek bakirdar kisam ka jo chief minister tha sabika, Mehdisha ne usne yahan pe usko postpone kar diya tha. Hamari koshish hai ki usko dobara se hum bahal kar rahe hain yahan pe, taaki ye hai ki haqeeqi taur pe koi sahafat ho.
वरना
जो साहबत के साथ खेलेंगे थामून के साथ भी हमें खेलना आता है, लेकिन ये है कि अगर कानून के मुताबिक वाकई साहबत ही करनी है, रियासत का चौथा सुकून बन के हमने अपना किरदार अदा करना है, तो उसके लिए हमें उम्मीद दे देता है कि हम ये कि किसी भी इदारे के अंदर घुस के हम वहाँ से जो बाकायदा प्रॉपर एक एप्लीकेशन दे के हमें जो रिक्वायरमेंट देता है वो लेके आवाम को अवेयरनेस देने की हम कोशिश कर सकते हैं।
Those who dare to raise their voice against the government are slapped with charges as grave as sedition. A number of them has been sent behind the bars for the same. And not just individuals, but the entire media house is locked if it tries to publish the reality. That's all we have for you this week. Your comments and suggestions are important to us. Do give us your feedback at myindia@anin.com. I'm your host Yeshi, and it's goodbye from the entire production team.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.